In order to make DNA research more useful, you need to attach your DNA to a family tree. Today, I'm going to show you how you can add your DNA to WikiTree and add your WikiTree profile to your GEDmatch profile. Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, where we help you understand your DNA, climb your family tree, and write your ancestor stories along the way. In previous videos, I showed you how you can add a GEDcom file to your GEDmatch profile. Now what we want to do is we want to add our WikiTree profile to that GEDmatch profile. In order to do this, we need to be over on the WikiTree website. Now I've already logged in, and the first step is to go to your WikiTree. I've created just a simple tree with myself, one of my parents, and a grandparent to show you how you can add this DNA profile. I'm going to click on my grandfather and we're going to add DNA to his profile. On the profile page, I want to edit the profile. And then in this first paragraph, there is a link that says edit DNA tests here. We click on that and now we can edit our DNA. Now it's telling me that there is no test information yet because I've not added anything. And as well, there is this box to inform you that you can add DNA for yourself or for non-living people as long as you manage those kits. In my case, my grandfather has already passed away and I manage his kit, so I can add the DNA to the WikiTree website. Next, we're going to scroll down and we're going to add a test. The first thing we want to do is we want to select which DNA test. And I'm going to select 23andMe. Now, for each test, it's going to have you enter different information. This is completely optional, but it can also help in some of the research. So for 23andMe, they do report to your Y chromosome haplogroup, your mitochondrial haplogroup. And then there's two other bits of information. If you have uploaded this kit to MitoY DNA, or if you've uploaded it to GEDmatch, it allows you to enter that ID. So I'm going to come down here to the GEDmatch ID, and I'm going to put in his GEDmatch ID. There's also a box if you need to put any other information, then you can put some notes in there. And now I can add this test. So we can see that this test has been added. And what this does is this does not transfer any information into WikiTree. What it does is it flags the tree so that people know that there has been a DNA test taken. So if somebody else matches on 23andMe and they go to WikiTree, then they're going to be able to find my grandfather. Or if you're searching around WikiTree and you think you might have found a potential relative, you can look for a DNA tag to see if they have and see which websites they might have tested on to actually go and see whether or not you match DNA with that person. There are some other tools that WikiTree has for using DNA, which I'm not going to go over in this video. I'll do over those in a later video. But as of right now, we've added a DNA kit to WikiTree. So the next question is, how does this show up on GEDmatch? Well, over on GEDmatch, if we go into the person profile, that's where we're going to see this link to WikiTree. Now, this is not going to happen right away. It takes about 24 hours to 48 hours for GEDmatch to do a communication with WikiTree to find what new kits have been added. So you're not going to see it right away. But after a day or two, you should be able to see this. You go into your kit, into your management, and as you scroll down near the very bottom, there is going to be a link here that says WikiTree link. There's some settings that you want to consider. So for instance, you can have this as disabled, in which case this link is not going to show up. You can have this as enable if no alias. What this means is that if you use an alias, the WikiTree link is not going to show up. Let me change it to enable if no alias so that you can see. So I've changed my access now. And you'll notice that this is saying that the WikiTree link is not publicly available. That's because on my account, I have an alias, ALM3. So in order for your WikiTree link to be visible, you want to make sure that this enable even if alias is clicked. And I'm going to change it enable even with alias. Now, if you have a reason not to enable it then that's fine. So I've clicked on that again, and now we can see that WikiTree link is publicly available. So when people search and my match comes up, they're gonna see that I have a WikiTree link as well as a GEDcom link if there's a GEDcom file attached. In this case, I haven't attached a GEDcom file to this particular kit. Now, whenever I do a search, these are how it's going to show up. If you just have a GEDcom file, it's going to show up as GED. If you have a WikiTree link, then it's going to show up as Wiki. And clicking on that link will actually go back to the WikiTree website so you can see where that person fits in the tree. Now, I want to stress that it takes a day or two for that link between WikiTree and GEDmatch to occur. You don't put your WikiTree link into GEDmatch. It happens automatically when you link your GEDmatch kit number to your WikiTree profile. And what happens if you want to delete a profile? Well, you can do that too. So for instance, I'm going to go down to myself and I'm going to go back to edit and I'm going to edit the DNA tests here. Now it's going to show me which DNA tests I've linked to this profile. So in this case, I've linked a 23andMe test to my profile and I've linked a ancestry test to my profile. I can change the details of that test or I can delete that test. So in this case, I'm going to go down and I'm going to delete my ancestry DNA test. It's going to ask me to confirm whether I want to delete this test. I say yes. And then that test is deleted. And you can see now I just have the 23andMe test, but I can always add a new test if I want to. That is a great way that you can link your GEDmatch kit numbers to WikiTree and have that link going back. There are lots of tools that are helpful once you have trees linked in both programs. And so I'd encourage you, if you don't have your DNA kits linked to a tree, then go and link them either with a GEDcom file or with WikiTree. Now, if you'd like to learn how you can link them with a GEDcom file, you can just watch this video up here. And if you want to learn more about GEDmatch and some of the tools you can use on it, then check out this playlist right down below. And if you like this video, leave a comment below and be sure to subscribe to our channel.